Hello, and in this video I'm going to be covering logic arithmetic in microcontrollers. You can use this with any microcontroller that supports C, like the AVRs, PIC, and ARM-based microcontrollers. For this example, I'm going to use a PIC as the base, just to demonstrate. The hardware setup is LEDs connected to port B, and a switch connected to RD1 on port D. Okay, now let's have a look at the theory. Now the basic setup here is the logic table of the operation, which is over here, the Boolean logic symbol, which is this, the Boolean arithmetic symbol here, the C arithmetic operator, and then the logic operator. The logic operator just refers to stuff you use with the if statement, for, and while statement. Now the first operator I'm going to cover is the AND. And the AND, if you give it inputs, the only time you get an output from it is when all the inputs are ones. So 01 is equals to 0, 00 is equals to 0, 11 is equals to 1, and 10 is equals to 0. Your Boolean logic symbol for it is either a time symbol or a dot. Your C arithmetic for it is a single ampersand, and your logic statements uses a double ampersand for it. Then we have an OR gate, which is represented by this symbol. And now an OR gate, if any of its inputs are 1, it gives you an output. So 01 gives you 1, 00 gives you 0, 11 gives you 1, and then 10 gives you 1. Now its Boolean arithmetic symbol is a plus, its C arithmetic symbol is a pipe, and then your logic statement is a double pipe. And then we have an XOR gate, which only if one of its inputs are a 1 and the rest are 0, it will give you an output. So 01 gives you 1, 00 gives you 0, 11 gives you 0, and then 10 gives you 1. And this is the symbol they use for it. And then the Boolean logic symbol is a circle with a plus inside. The C arithmetic symbol is this cap symbol. Then we have this long operation to do it, since there is no logic operator in C to do an exclusive OR with. So it's this whole thing knotted with NOT1 and input 2, ORed with input 1 and NOT input 2. And then we have the NOT gate, which simply takes the input and gives you the opposite out. So 0 becomes 1 and 1 becomes 0. Now, this is the symbol they use for it. They don't usually use the stripe in the middle. I'm just using that for ease of explanation. And this one should have a circle around it, just by the way. So the Boolean symbol is a stripe above your current input variable or output. They use the tilt key as the C arithmetic operator, and then for logic operation, an exclamation mark. And then we have our logical bit shifts, which is left and right. For our left, we have double arrow symbols pointing to the left to do a leftwise operation, and double arrows to the right for a rightwise operation. Now, anything following the symbol is by how much you will shift your variable. So in this case, I'm shifting by 7, so bit 0 moves to bit 7, and bit 1 moves to bit 6. I see now this is a 6-wise shift, 6-bit shift, and not a 7-bit shift. So we just quickly fix that. 6, and then 6 over here. Okay, so each bit moves by 6, so 1 goes to 7, and then 0 goes to 6 in this operations case. And then you have a right shift, bit 7 will go to bit 1, and then bit 6 will go to bit 0. Now we can have a look at the practical code. Now the code is a basic setup for a PIC. I have a button as an input, which I'm going to wait for to step my logic. Then I have my oscillator set to 8 MHz. I have the B port set as an output, my D1 set as an input, and then the UART initialized, which I'm not using. And then we have the basic operations over here. Now, for most of the operations I'm going to use, I'm going to set bit 7 and bit 0 on let B, and then my secondary operation will have bit 7 up and then bit 3 as the thing I'm using a logic operand with. Now, the first is going to be an AND with the two symbols, and that will result in the following, with only a 1 in bit 7. And then we are going to do a OR statement, which will result with a 1 in bit 7, a 1 in bit 3, and a 1 in bit 0. And then we have the exclusive OR, which will result in a 1 in bit 3 and a 1 in bit 0. Then we have the NOT operation, which I'm going to use a 1 in bit 7 and 6, and then again a 1 in bit 1 and 0. And then we're going to NOT it, and that's going to give a 1 in 5, 4, 3, and 2, and the other 4 bits will be 0. And then we have a logic shift to right by 1, which will just move all these 1s to the position, to the 0 position, and then we have a logic shift to right, which will then again move this result back to the previous result. Now let's have a look at the practical application, practical execution of this code. Now, as you can see by the practical indication, the red and green LED being 1. Just for reference, bit 7 is the red LED and bit 0 is the green LED. Now we're currently at this value. Now we're going to step over to this value. Now you can see bit 7 and bit 3 being on. And then we're going to AND the two values, and then only bit 7 will be on. As you can see, bit 7 is on. Now we load the value again. Then we load next value, which is over here. And then we OR the two values together, which gives us bit 0 on, bit 3 on, and bit 7 on. And then we load the two values again, which is here now. And we load the next value, and then we XOR the two to get them, to get the value out. So you can see bit 0 is on and bit 3 is on, but bit 7 is off. Then we have a NOT execution, so we step through. You can see bit 1 and 0 on and 7 and 6 on, and now when I push the button, it's going to invert that. So as we can see, bit 5, 4, 3, and 2 are on instead of the current ones. And then we have the logic shift. It's operation where we have the value first. Now you can see all the red LEDs on. And then we have the logic shift by 1 to the right. That turns all the green LEDs on. And then we have a logic shift to the left, which will turn on all the red LEDs again. And then we start from a start again. And that's a basic introduction to using logic arithmetic in C for microcontrollers. Any parts that I've used will be linked down in the description. Any code that I've written will be linked to my Git. A like, share, comment, and subscribe would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.